In this problem, we have been given that we have to integrate dx by sine to the power 6x plus cos to the power 6x. Now, I will suggest everyone to pause the video right now and try this sum by your own. If you cannot do it, come back to the video and see the solution. And one more thing. If you are new to this channel, please do subscribe and press the bell icon so that you get notified to each and every video I upload. And don't forget to like, share and comment on the video. So please take a break and try to do this sum. And if you cannot do it, again I'm telling you, come back to this video to see the solution. Right? Okay, so how to solve this problem? What I will do is basically, I will divide numerator and denominator with sec to the power 6x. I will multiply with sec to the power 6x. That is, I am dividing both numerator and denominator with cos to the power 6x. So we are getting what? Tan to the power 6x plus 1. Is it clear? Now, sec to the power 6x can be written as sec to the power 4x into sec square x divided by 1 plus tan to the power 6x. Okay? So, sec to the power 4x into sec square x dx divided by, this is 1 cube plus tan square x whole cube. So I am applying a cube plus b cube formula in the denominator. So we are having, this is basically sec square x whole square, sec square x dx, and a cube plus b cube formula, a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. Is it clear? Now you take, let tan x is p, therefore sec square x dx is dp. Therefore my integration becomes, now one more thing you must remember, this sec square x can be written as 1 plus tan square x, that is 1 plus p square whole square dp divided by p to the power 4 minus p square plus 1 into 1 plus p square. Okay, this 1 plus p square is for 1 plus tan square x. Is it clear? So now 1 plus p square and 1 plus p square from numerator and denominator will get cancelled. So we are left with 1 plus p square divided by p to the power 4 minus p square plus 1 dp. Is it clear? Now, if you observe, you will find that in the denominator, we are having the degree of the expression as 4 and the degree of expression in the numerator is 2. So, this is nothing but your special integrals. So, we have to divide both numerator and denominator by p square. So, we are getting basically divided by p square minus 1 plus 1 by p square. Is it fine? Okay. Now, p square plus 1 by p square, that is a square plus b square formula I will use here. It is p minus 1 by p whole square plus 2ab minus 1. Why I have expanded a square plus b square like a minus b whole square plus 2ab instead of a plus b whole square minus 2ab. This you will understand if you go through my video of special integrals. Okay, there you will understand why I have expanded the thing in a minus b whole square plus 2ab instead of a plus b whole square minus 2ab. So we are having basically 1 plus 1 by p square p minus 1 by p whole square. So here we are getting plus 2 minus 1. So it is plus 1. Again, take let P minus 1 by P is, let us say, this is T. Therefore, 1 plus, if I differentiate, we are having is dt. Is it clear? Therefore, my integration becomes what? Integration dt by t square plus 1, which is nothing but tan inverse t plus c. Is it okay? Now, tan inverse t can be written as tan inverse, replace this t by p minus 1 by p. And replace P by 10x. So we are having what? Tan inverse 10x minus 1 by 10x plus C. Or else you can write this thing as tan inverse 10 square x minus 1 divided by 10x plus C. Is it clear to all of you? Okay, see you in my next video. Take care.